Today's topic is about the vaccine approval process, and I know there have been concerns about different kinds of approaches. We want to educate and walk you through both processes, the normal process as well as the emergency use authorization, and we want you to be assured that both focus on patient safety and will be very closely monitored before, during, and after the vaccine has been rolled out. Let me guide you first through the first process, the regular approval process. Usually you start out with candidates, which can be chemical substances, can be proteins, and they are tested in the lab, and if they show promise, they're investigated further. The next step would be to investigate them in animal models and see, do they cause harm, are they safe, do they cause an immune response with antibodies or a protective reaction against that component, against the virus or the microorganism. And only after that has been done, it goes into the phase where we humans come into play with a phase one study where we look for safety in a small group of healthy volunteers, and we look for what we call immunogenicity, which means, does the vaccine really cause and evoke an immune response that we want? And does it depend on certain doses we use? The next two phases, phase two and phase three, deal with larger groups of humans. And again, we look for safety. And only after these three phases have been accomplished, then you can apply at the Food and Drug Administration for approval of this vaccine. And you have to bring significant proof of safety and efficacy of that vaccine in order to get it approved. So you cannot simply say it works. You have to bring proof of that, and only then the FDA will approve it. Now, once this approval is accomplished, it does not stop there. And that's what I want everybody to know. The FDA is very closely monitoring any vaccine, any drug that has been released and approved on the market for post-marketing events such as rare complications that might not have shown up in the first studies, or also whether the efficacy wanes over time. So this is really an ongoing process that assures the safety and security of the population that receives that vaccine. Usual process takes about 10 to 15 years, and more than two-thirds of the candidate that start out are actually dropped and fall out on the way. So this is something that is a long process, as you can imagine. In the current situation with a pandemic like COVID-19, you understand that we do not have 10, 15 years. We need to get things moving faster. And this is where a second approval process comes into play, the emergency use authorization. Now, whereas the regular process is more intended for permanent approval, the EUA is a temporary approval. And the EUA is used in settings where you have an emergent situation like we have now with the COVID pandemic, and where we want to try a drug or a vaccine that shows promise and shows no significant safety concerns in the absence of other alternatives. So if you, for example, have a disease where 50% of the people who get it die, you would be happy to have a drug that could reduce this to 25%. That would already be a big gain. So this is an expedited process where actually the preclinical trials, the clinical trials, and the assessment for safety and efficacy goes in parallel. So that's why this process can be rolled out faster. What I want to assure everybody that this is intended as a temporary approval, but that the FDA and the professional societies will still monitor after the vaccines have been released. So this is definitely something where we will have a close eye on, do any concerns about efficacy or side effects emerge after that. We will address this as a medical community and as a Food and Drug Administration right away.